children, how are you all? Hope you are all doing well now and safe at home. Today I am going to discuss the topic food chain and food waves from the chapter Our Environment. So now let's start the chapter now. Food chain and food waves. What is food chain? First of all, we need to know. Food chain is the process where the organisms are eating each other. The process of being eaten and eating other is known as food chain. And food wave, in a community, there are lot many food chain existing. So there will be interrelationship between the food chain. So interrelationship between the food chain is termed as food waves. So here you can see that ecosystem. In the ecosystem, this is the relationship between producers and consumers. This food chain and food wave depicts that relationship. So the characteristics of food chain, it is a sequential process. Why it is called a sequential process? Because in a food chain, the first level is the producer. Next, it goes to the second level, that is primary consumer, then secondary consumer, then tertiary consumer. So the process starts from the producer and it ends with the top consumer level. So it is a sequential process. Second characteristic states that it is a straight line. So food chain always forms a straight line, because whenever we are representing a food chain, the organisms are represented with an arrow in between. So it forms a straight line. Next is members decrease at the successive level. If you see the food chain, that the producer level number is always the highest, and the number of the organisms at the successive level will go on decreasing. Okay, now the definition of food wave, the interrelationships between different food chain is termed as food wave. Now let us take one example of food chain. In the first example, we can see that plants are eaten by grasshopper. Grasshopper in turn is eaten by hawk. So here only three biotic levels are there. First level is the plant, which is the producer level. It is eaten by the grasshopper. Grasshopper consists the second level, that is the primary consumer level. And grasshopper is being eaten by the hawk. So here it is the top carnivore. It is also consumer. Let us take the second food chain example. Plants being eaten by grasshopper, which is being eaten by frog. Frog in turn is eaten by snake, and snake is eaten by hawk. So hawk occupies the topmost level in this food chain. And this, in this food chain, we can see that there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 levels. Okay, and each level is known as trophic level. So what is trophic level? The level, that is the biotic level in a food chain, is termed as trophic level. So plants here forms the first trophic level, grasshopper second trophic level, frog third trophic level, and snake and hawk, they are the top consumers, so they form the fourth trophic level. All right, next come to the example of food wave. As I told you that in a food wave, there are lot many food chains will be existing, and there will be interrelationship between the food chains. Here we can see total 5 number of food chains are existing together. Let us take the first food chain. Grasshopper starts from plants. Plants will be eaten by grasshopper. Grasshopper in turn is eaten by hawk. This is the first food chain. In the second food chain, plants is being eaten by grasshopper. Grasshopper is being eaten by lizard. Lizard is being eaten by hawk. In the third food chain, plants is being eaten by rabbit. Rabbit is being eaten by hawk. In the fourth food chain, plants is being eaten by mouse. Mouse is being eaten by snake, and snake in turn is being eaten by hawk. In the last food chain, plants is being eaten by mouse, and mouse is being eaten by hawk. You can see the interrelationship. Here grasshopper, lizard, hawk, again mouse, snake, hawk, again plants, rabbit, hawk. So there will be interrelationship among the food chains, because each organism will be dependent on one another. So this forms the food web. As I told you, trophic level means the biotic levels existing in a food chain. So if we see the pictorial representation of a food chain, we will see that the organisms existing in a food chain will form a pyramid shape. Why this shape? Because the numbers of organisms from the producer to the top consumers will always go on decreasing. The numbers of organisms at the producer levels are the highest, and it will decrease at the primary consumer level. Then again it will decrease in the secondary consumer level. Then again it will decrease tertiary consumer level. As a result, it forms the pyramid shape. So first level, second level, third level, fourth level. So here four trophic levels are existing. The definition of trophic level: the various steps in a food chain at which the transfer of energy takes place are called trophic levels. So now we will see the textbook. Please open your textbook and we will discuss this pyramid once again. Now you see in your book one example of a food web is given here, and the figures, food chain in nature, in forest, and that is the previous previous example, and this one is the food web example. Okay, now here in the second para, see, each step or level of the food chain forms a trophic level. You can underline this line. The autotrophs or the producers are at the first trophic level. They fix up the solar energy and make it available for heterotrophs or the consumers. That means autotrophs, plants, they will transfer the solar energy in the form of food energy or chemical energy to the consumer level. The herbivores or the primary consumers come at the second, small carnivores, and the secondary consumers at the third, and the larger carnivores or the tertiary consumers form the fourth trophic level. So in a food chain we can see nearly four trophic levels. Now here you can mark sources of energy. Always remember that producers, they will trap the solar energy, so they will make the food. They will trap the solar energy. Only 1% of the energy is available for the producers, and they will transfer the energy to the successive level. Now you see the second diagram. This is a trophic level diagram. We have already discussed here four trophic levels are there. So main important point here: the green plants in a terrestrial ecosystem capture about 1% of the energy of sunlight that falls on their leaves and convert it into food energy. So sunlight is falling on the producers, but they can utilize only 1% of the sunlight energy. After they utilize this 1% of energy, only 10% of the energy will be transfer to the next level, that is the primary consumer level. And primary consumer level, after completion of all the biochemical activities, they will utilize the energy and they will transfer again 10% of energy to the secondary consumer. Secondary consumer in turn will transfer only 10% of energy to the tertiary consumer. So you can see that the energy will be going on decreasing at each successive level. When green plants are eaten by primary consumers, a great deal of energy is lost. That is why energy is decreasing. The energy is lost as heat to the environment. Some amount will go for digestion, some amount will go for doing work, and some will go towards growth and reproduction. So whatever is left, that is only 10% for transfer to the successive level. Therefore, 10% can be taken as the average value for the amount of organic matter that is present at each step and reaches the next level of consumers. This is called 10% law. Since so little energy is available for the next level of consumers, food chains generally consist of only 3 or 4 steps. Because after 4th step, the energy will be so less that it will be insufficient to sustain the life. So in a food chain, we can see only 3 or 4 trophic levels. The loss of energy at each step is so great that very little usable energy remains after 4th trophic level. There are generally greater number of individuals at the lower trophic level. As you can see, the producer level here, the number of the producers are the highest and it will go on decreasing at the top level. Okay, now let's see the chart once again. Come to the chart now. This picture we have already discussed. Okay, so these are the trophic levels. So producers, they will trap 1% of sunlight energy. After the use of that energy, only 10% energy will be available for transfer to the herbivores. And herbivores, after using that energy, they will also leave only 10% of energy to transfer to the carnivores, and carnivores in turn will transfer only 10% of energy to the top carnivore. So we can see that energy is going in unidirectional way. Okay, from producer to the top carnivores. Whatever energy is going from the producer to the successive level, it cannot come back. It cannot return back to the producer. That is why we can say that flow of energy is unidirectional. So this is the diagram showing flow of energy in an ecosystem. Now 10% law. 10% law, it was given by the scientist Raymond. It states that only 10% of the energy entering a particular trophic level of organisms is available for transfer to the next higher trophic level. That is, the energy available at each successive trophic level is 10% of the previous level. Alright, so one thing you must remember, that the energy which is going from producer to the top carnivore, it cannot return back to the previous level. Now come to the next question. This question comes in your exam also. Why the number of trophic levels in a food chain is limited? Food chains always consist of 4 or 3 trophic levels, because after 4th trophic level, the energy is so less that it will be insufficient to sustain the life. So here it states, food chains generally consist of 3 or 4 steps, because the energy available for the next level of consumers is progressively decreased. And after 3rd or 4th trophic level, the available energy will be so less that it will be insufficient to sustain the life of that organism. That is why the number of trophic levels in a food chain is limited. Now, the next thing what we need to know, what is known as biomagnification. If we see any food chain, you will see either man or the top carnivores like peacock or hawk always occupies the topmost level. Here in this food chain, you can see peacock occupies the topmost level. Grass is eaten by grasshopper. Grasshopper is being eaten by frog. Frog is being eaten by snake. Snake is being eaten by peacock. So here, peacock occupies the topmost level. So the level of biomagnification will be highest here for the peacock. If in any food chain, the highest level, the topmost level is occupied by man or hawk, then they will have the maximum biomagnification. So what is biomagnification? The increase in concentration of harmful chemical substances like pesticides in the body of living organisms at each trophic level of a food chain is called biological magnification. You know, farmers are using pesticides in the field. So from the producer, those chemicals like pesticides, they are being passed to the next successive level, like herbivores, then carnivores, because carnivores are eating the herbivores. Herbivores are eating the plants. So pesticides are keeping on accumulated in their bodies. So learn this biological magnification. The question will come like, in which level in this food chain the level of biomagnification will be highest? You have to say that peacock, since it occupies the topmost level, so it will have maximum level of biomagnification here. I think you have understood. Now you go through the chapter thoroughly. So today we have completed the topic food chain and food wave. So I think you have understood it well. We will meet in the next class. Thank you.